Hi, this is Abhiram and welcome back to my channel. In the previous video in this series, we saw the concepts of subcontracting and multi-level subcontracting. In today's video, we are going to see the configurations and the end-to-end execution of the simple subcontracting scenario in SAP S/4HANA. Note that the configurations for subcontracting are very much similar to that of a normal FIMM integration. But in addition to that, there are certain account determination settings that are to be done in OBYC transaction code, especially for subcontracting postings. For example, if we refer back to the same accounting entries for the goods receipt, we are having the final product stock debit and the subcontracting inventory change account to be credited. So for this, we need to have the respective accounts to be entered in the BSX and the BSV account in OBYC. Now, coming to the raw material consumption and raw material stock, we need to have the accounts entered in GBB under VBO account modifier and BSX account keys in OBYC. Similarly, for subcontracting charges and the GRIR account, we need to have the GL accounts entered in the account keys FRL and WRX respectively. So many of these are same from the FIMM integration related configurations, but we are having few additional such as FRL for the subcontracting charges and BSV for the subcontracting inventory change. In addition to this, we also need to have the special procurement type 30 configured for the plant in which we are going to perform the subcontracting so that the system will understand that the particular material is being procured via subcontracting method. Let us jump into the system and see these configurations and also the end-to-end execution. We are in SAP S/4HANA 2020 system. So under SPRO transaction code, under the node materials management, under consumption-based planning, under master data, we are having this node called define special procurement types. So here we need to assign a special procurement type 30 for our plant. So we are using the plant SON1, and in this plant, we are having the special procurement type 30 assigned. So if you see the details, the procurement type here is F, which is external procurement. That means whatever material which is having the special procurement type 30 assigned in the material master data, the system will understand that this material is to be procured from an external source. And the nature of procurement or the special procurement type here is L, which means subcontracting. Now let's go to the transaction OBYC to see the account assignment related configurations. First one, let us go to the transaction BSX, which is for the inventory posting. So in our chart of accounts, depending upon whether the final product that we are receiving from the subcontracting vendor is treated as a semi-finished product or a finished product, we need to have that particular valuation class and we need to have the respective stock account sign here. So if you see this, in our case, we are considering that the final product that we receive from the subcontracting vendor is treated as semi-finished goods in our plant. So for the valuation class 7900, which is for the semi-finished goods, we are having the stock account A0002 assigned here. Now let us formulate a scenario in order to execute the end-to-end subcontracting process. We are having a raw material which is called as SON1 laptop, and the valuation class is raw material. This raw material is issued to the vendor, the subcontracting vendor, and this in along with another raw material which is called as SON1 label for laptop. So these are the two raw materials which are issued to the vendor. The vendor will do some activity using these two raw materials, and the final product which is again received from the subcontracting vendor is a semi-finished goods, and it is named as SON1 laptop with label. So these are the three raw materials that we have, and we're having a business partner which is a subcontracting vendor. Now let us execute the entire process, right, from creation of a purchase order till posting of an invoice in SAP. First, we need to create a bill of materials for the semi-finished goods, which is the final product that we are receiving from the subcontracting vendor. And the components of this semi-finished goods will be the two raw materials which are used in order to create this semi-finished goods. So let us go to the transaction CS01, and here for this semi-finished goods material, so we are having a material named as SON1 labeled laptop. For this one, the BOM usage is 1. We are having two components, and the item category will be L, which is a stock item. So the first component is the SON1 laptop RM, which is the main raw material. And the second one is the label which is used for this laptop. So these are the two materials which are the components for this SON1 labeled laptop. And the quantity that we require for this is 1 unit each. Now we have created a bill of materials, and this bill of materials is to be maintained in the material master data for this semi-finished goods, so that whenever we are creating a purchase order on this semi-finished goods, the purchase order will automatically explode the bill of materials Now let us go to transaction MM02 and edit this material. So under MRP4, we're having production versions. So let us go to the production version. And here, if you're already having an entry, then just go to the details. If you do not have any entry, just create an item, give some name for this version, and just go to details. Here, you need to maintain the alternative bill of materials and the bill of material usage as per what you have created earlier in CS01. So we have created the bill of materials with the usage as 1, and there is no alternative BOM given. So let us give 1 here and continue. An important point to consider here is the validity of the bill of materials that we have just now created. So here the validity of this bill of materials is on 18th of September. So we need to ensure that whatever purchase orders that we are creating on this material should have the delivery date in future to that of this validity date of the bill of materials. Only then the purchase order will be able to identify the components of that material and explore the bill of materials once we save the purchase order. Now let us create the purchase order. So we're having a subcontracting supplier, and let us give the header details, the purchase order, the purchase group, and the company code. One of the major differences between a normal purchase order and a purchase order for a subcontracting is the item category. The item category for a subcontracting purchase order material should have the value as L, which is subcontracting. And here we are going to give the final product that we are supposed to receive from the subcontracting vendor. This is the PO quantity, and let us give the plant. Let us maintain the price of this material. Let us give it as 1000. And here if you see, it is giving the error message as not possible to determine any components. So let us go and change the delivery date to future date. So let us keep it at 3 days later. And let us also change the purchase order date to the future. And now let us go to the material data and let us try to select the components. Now the system is able to automatically fetch the components from the bill of materials, and if we click on the explode bill of materials, it will successfully explode the bill of materials. So this is the error message that I was talking before, which is dependent on the validity from date of the bill of materials that we have created for this material. Now let us save the purchase order. Now once we save the purchase order, the next step is to issue the goods to the vendor. So whatever components that we have in this purchase order should be first delivered or issued to the vendor from our inventory, and only then the vendor will be able to do the activity on this material. So first for that, let us go to the transaction code MIGO. Here you can do a transfer posting based on the purchase order. And here if you see this, automatically the movement type has been changed to 541, which is from our warehouse to the subcontracting stock. That means this quantity, whatever we are going to enter here, will be reserved for the subcontracting stock. Now let us give the header text as stock to subcontracting, storage location details, and item OK. Here if you see, although we are creating this transfer posting on this semi-finished goods, the system is able to explode the bill of materials, and it is showing the two components that we are having here. So for each of this one, let us select item OK. Let us enter the storage location details and post it. Now after the goods issue, let us see the impact from the materials management side. Let us go to the transaction code MMBE, and for this particular material, let us see the stock. So here if you see, for this material, out of the total quantity which we have, quantity 10 has been put aside as an on-order stock for subcontracting. And we do not have any accounting impact as we discussed in the previous video. Now the next step is to post the goods receipt for the purchase order. By posting the goods receipt, we mean that the vendor had performed the activity or the value addition onto the two raw materials that we have supplied or that we have issued to the vendor. And now we are receiving the semi-finished goods, which is a labeled laptop. And for that, we need to enter a goods receipt. Now this is the goods receipt. Here let us select item OK and enter the storage location details and post it. Now let us display this document and see the impact in account. So this is the same accounting entries that we have discussed in the previous video. The semi-finished goods stock, which is nothing but the final product, the labeled laptop stock, has been debited, and change in subcontracting inventory is credited. Similarly, for the goods that we have received, the GRIR account is credited and the subcontracting charges is debited. Now, these four entries belong to the two components that we are having in this semi-finished goods. For each of the component, the raw material stock account is credited and the consumption account is debited. Now, the final step of this subcontracting process is to enter the invoice which we receive from the vendor. So for this, let us select item OK and enter the amount. So the GRIR account is debited and the vendor account is credited. So this is the end-to-end process of the simple subcontracting scenario. Stay tuned for the next video, wherein we will discuss the multi-level subcontracting from the configuration perspective and the execution perspective. Until then, stay tuned. Goodbye.